Pastor Jamie here, and excited that you have joined us for this online Bible study. And just want to let you know that I'm going to be using the Blackboard to do some things. I've seen this in Khan Academy, and even John Piper has used this. So you're going to see me scribbling some notes, and hopefully it will help us all slow down a bit in Bible study. And that's what I want you to do, to kind of slow down and go with me as we try to study the Word. I'll change that because I don't like the way the S looks. Slow down. And we're going to be on about 7:45 every Wednesday night. And I've been preaching on Wednesdays, and I like that. I love it, actually. But this is an opportunity to reach more people, maybe, and help people on the go. And so I encourage you to let me know by comments. Let me know that you're present. And say, hey, I'm here. That's all you got to do. And maybe you have questions. If you have any kind of questions that come up, I'm going to ask you to send that by DM, which is direct message, either through Praise Assembly or Jamie-Kim Gagne Gardner, and just send a direct message of a question, and I will try to either address that to you personally one-on-one, or possibly I can put it out there as to answer a question some people may have and do a Blackboard answering questions, which I think would be great too. Let me start off with a premise that I want you to know. We believe the Scripture is the Word of God and is inspired by God, 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17. And we believe the Scripture is profitable. If I guaranteed you a profit today, something profitable, you would take me up on it. Well, the Bible says it's profitable for your life. The Bible is profitable for your life. And so, how does it profit you? It teaches you God's ways and God's desires, points you to Jesus. Reproof, meaning the Word of God will show you where you're wrong, show you where you've messed up or misguided or where we lack wisdom. But at the same time, He gives correction. God doesn't leave us down. He picks us up, shows us the Word, how to do it, the how-to. And then there's a training manual called the Word of God. It trains us in righteousness so that we can be equipped. Equip believers. I think that of all the things I've seen at times, I get discouraged when I see believers that don't know the Word. They're not equipped. We want you to be equipped. And we believe Hebrews 4:12 that says the Word of God is sharper than any double-edged sword. So the Word of God penetrates our hearts, and the Word of God is also a weapon that we use against the enemy. So in that mindset, I want you to go with me as I go to a scripture in Romans chapter 8. And I'm planning on doing all of Romans chapter 8, but tonight, because it's the first one, I want to hit on a scripture in Romans chapter 8 that kind of parallels a song that you and I may have listened to before. So go with me for a moment to Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. This is Romans 8. Just make sure you know where we are. Romans 8 and verse 12. And I want you to notice this as I walk through this, the scripture. And the beauty of this is what it says here. Romans chapter 8. So brothers, we are debtors, not to the flesh. If we live according to the flesh, if you live according to the flesh, we don't live in that. We're not to live according to the flesh. We're not a debtor to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. I will speak on that again in the future about having victory in your body, victory over addiction and victory over sin. You can have victory. By the Spirit you put to death those deeds. But here's what I want you to notice. You can do those things, and there's victory by your identity. And who are you? It says right here, for all who are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. All who are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. The beauty of that scripture is that we are not only led by God's Spirit, God leads us, but we are considered His sons, His daughters, His children. We are now children of God. We belong to Him. Notice verse 17. We're children. We're children of God. And I'll share that more in just a moment. But those who are led by the Spirit of God, those who follow what Christ has done at the cross, and the Spirit of God lives inside of you, you are a child of God. Now, and I want you to notice this. Check this next verse out, right? Notice what he says here. I love, again, I want to just encourage in this. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery You did not receive the spirit of slavery. God doesn't want slaves in fear, right? To fall back into fear. God's not looking for slaves. He's not looking for people fearful. He's looking for sons. And that's what he says here. You've received the spirit of adoption. The spirit of adoption. The spirit that says you're mine and you have a family and you belong to me because of what Christ did. And you have adoption as sons. By whom? By his spirit we cry, Abba, Father. That the Abba means a very endearing term like Papa. We have a relationship with God, not one of fear. Hallelujah, I'm excited. Not one of fear, but one of love and acceptance through what Christ has done for us. And so you did not receive that fear as a child of God. You don't receive the spirit of fear. You receive the spirit of adoption. He even says this in Galatians. Chapter 4. He says, I love this. But when the fullness of time had come, at the right time, God sent forth his son. Let me say this. He did it out of love. He did not have to do this. God did not have to save anybody. Remember that. He did not have to save anybody. But he sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law. Notice this. That we might receive adoption as sons. And here you go. Ready? And because you are sons, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. That cry for God is the Spirit of God crying inside of us, crying out, Father. Think about it. His Spirit is in us, crying out for the Father, knowing that we're never alone and we're never isolated. And the beauty of that is the next verse. The beauty of it is this verse that says, you are no longer slaves, but a son. Then an heir through God. And if a son, then an heir through God. You are no longer slaves, but a son. Think about it. That you have been redeemed. You have received adoption. You have the Spirit of God inside of you, and the Spirit cries, Abba, Father, and you are considered a son. Which brings me back to Romans. Verse 16. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirits that we are children of God, and we're heirs, and we suffer with him. It's provided we suffer with him, we're heirs. So notice this, the Spirit of adoption as sons, we cry, Abba, Father. We've received this spirit and we did not receive the spirit of slavery to fear. So when you sing the song, as my good friend has actually quoted this scripture to this song, when we sing this song, we're no longer slaves. Know the song we sing, no longer slaves to fear. No, we're no longer slaves to fear. Free, let me erase that. We're no longer slaves to fear. We are a child of God. We are a child of God. I hope you take that with you tonight, that you're not a slave to fear. God has not given you the spirit of fear, power, love, and a sound mind. We have access. We have identity. We have forgiveness. We have everything. We have everything. Because of what Christ did for us. So let me pray for you. Father, I pray for each of my participants in this Bible study. I pray, Lord, they would walk in freedom and life and hope and being thankful for everything you've given them. And I pray tonight as they go to bed in a few hours, Lord, they would go to bed with peace, knowing they're not slaves to fear. They're children of God, loved by you, given everything. because of the cross. You've been given everything. And I praise you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you. Have a great Wednesday.